Hi guys, it's WNews.com and I'm here with the iPad mini, and this annoying little minion that you can see on the screen is a sign that I'm going to review the game Despicable Me Minion Rush, available now for free on iOS and Android. This is an endless runner. It's more vivid than your usual endless runner. As you can see, the graphics are more three-dimensional, if I can say that. It reminds me a bit of Subway Surfers. You can see that it tends to lag just a little bit on the iPad mini. You play as a minion, one of the yellow bubbly characters from the game Despicable Me, from the movie Despicable Me. By the way, Despicable Me 2 will be in cinema soon. And this is the game tie-in with the movie. Aside from running around in this endless runner, you will also be battling bosses. You can also revive the character if you have enough special coins. As usual, the game comes from Gameloft. And you probably know that Despicable Me 2 is going to arrive to the cinema soon. You start off in a lab, the Mad Scientist's Gru lab. And then you move on to the city and try to stay away from buses. Try to collect as many bananas as possible. The banana is the currency of the game. You can use it to buy power-ups. And by the way, you can also torture, punch and hit various minions to get the Despicable Me bonus and become more despicable. The idea is to become the minion of the year, and you can do that by being as despicable as possible. You can see that the game is funny, it's cute, it's for children, it's fast-paced, and it's reasonably easy to play. This is a 3D endless runner with a system of 3 lanes. And by 3 lanes I mean the center one, the left one, and the right one. Just like Subway Surfers. And a bit different from the Temple Run experience. Everyone sees Temple Run as the benchmark endless runner game. Well, I actually think that this one is better. And if you ask me, this is a better achievement for Gameloft than Iron Man 3. I know it's a big deal. It's also very important that the game is available for free. And it's also cute that we got these mini games, like this one with the unicorn. So if you run into an unicorn, you're going to tilt the tablet and try to get as many bananas as humanly possible. There are various other mini games. For example, you can get a rocket and see what happens. A lot of power-ups to pick up, and as I said, boss battles against a character called Vector. If you saw the cartoon, you know Vector from the first Despicable Me movie. Okay, now let's go to the shop, see what we can buy. You can buy a golden shield, a freeze ray, banana vacuum, banana splitter, minion shield, minion launcher, and Gru's rocket. So let's buy a rocket, see what we can do. You can also buy that fluffy unicorn. There are also tokens and stuff like that. And this is the main menu of the game. There's also a social aspect. There is a bunch of goals that you have to fulfill. You can skip them or continue them to reach the next multiplier. Here is my best score, 17,000 points. And now let's use the minion launcher. It will propel us to about 1,000 and a bit meters. It's a very fun game to play, and I almost got that rocket I was talking about, but not just yet. It's sad to not have the coins required to revive the character, but I'll get them next time. My only objection about the game is that it gets a bit too easy at times. I know I have died a lot of times, but it's actually easier than it seems. It's easier than many other endless running titles. I have to remind you that in many other games of this genre, you have to actually work a lot to reach 1,000 meters. Here you can even reach about, let's say, 10,000 meters without working a lot. The graphics are great, they're 3D, and also the sounds are great. The quirky characters are nice. And here's a new environment inside the house. And the good thing about this game is that it actually saves your progress. Unlike the other Temple Run related games out there, Here's a shield. There's a lot of stuff happening on the screen, as you can see, which makes this a bit more complex game than its rivals. Things are going frantic. Okay, folks, the game is Despicable Me, Minion Rush. If you like the movie, I guess that you like the game, and you probably go to see the new movie. A very action-packed game, and about 10,000 meters, I've just reached it. Okay, so time for the grade. The grade is 9.7 out of 10, with the only objection being that the game is too easy. I like the fact that you can save your progress, I like the fact that the environments are varied, and I like the fact that there are various mini-games integrated into the game, and the characters are cute, they're funny, they're quirky, they have a funny line, always prepared to surprise you, and overall, children and adults will love this title. Once again, it's available for free on Android and on iOS. This is the iPad Mini. I had a lot of fun playing the game. And this is tabletopnews.com with a grade of 9.7 out of 10 for this title. That's it, folks. Bye-bye.